And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Solano Gymnasium here on the campus of Solano Community College for this exciting Bay Valley Conference matchup between the visiting Yuba 49ers and your Solano Falcons right here on the Solano College Sports Network. My name is Brian Nelson, and joining with me in the booth today is Anthony Williams. And Anthony, this is going to be a tough matchup for Solano. Yuba coming in with an impressive 12-2 record, 2-0 in conference play. What does Solano have to do to pick up a victory here at home?
Well, Solano, they definitely have to score. With R.J. Lewis being the only person in averaging over 10 points per game, the rest of the Falcons have to step it up. And also, they have to play defense very good against Jalen Davis, Jahad Woods, and Eric Sheeve, like we've seen last year.
Yeah, last year, Yuba really put on a show here at Solano and shot very well. It left both of us with a very lasting impression. So Solano has a tough conference test, but we'll see if they can manage a good, well-balanced team play to answer Yuba. Both teams are undefeated in conference play. Only two games for Yuba and one for Solano. So we will see how this game will unfold right after this break. So when we come back, we will have the tip-off right after this.
Ever have an interest of being on camera as a sports broadcaster? Or have you ever wanted to learn how to operate a camera? Or what goes on behind the scenes?
If you want to be a star behind the camera,
or you could be the captain of everything behind the scenes, then we have just the program for you.
What did you know? That Solano College is the only community college in the nation that has a sports broadcasting program and television network, which can give you a certificate to get an entry-level job in sports broadcasting.
Classes will be held right along the library in room 121.
For more information, contact Greg Poff. That's me. At solano.edu. And remember, it's more than just sports. It's an education.
And welcome back, folks. Let's run down the starting lines for both teams. First, for the visiting Yuba 49ers, number 1, Jahad Woods, and number 3, Jalen Davis will be joined by number 11, Eric Sheeve, number 21, Josh Dott, and number 24, Jordan Johnson. For the Solano Falcons, you will have Anthony Bryant, number 0, number 11, Travis Sell, in the middle, big number 12, Tony Center, number 13, R.J. Lewis, and number 32, Dan Jazik. And right before we back on, you play AAU team as Dan Jazik. So tell the fans a little bit about Jazik before we tip off.
Well, Daniel Jazik, he's a very good three-point shooter. When we played AAU together, he didn't want to be on the post. He was a very good three-point shooter. And seeing how big he is, you wouldn't shoot the
ball. So we'll see. Stretch the floor as Yuba wins the tip. The one Jahad kick it back out to the lefty, Jalen Davis. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Good pick and foul. So the hoop and the harm as Josh Dott gets the three-point play opportunity.
Yeah, you see multiple screens set, and that's what freed him up. And he just simply drove to the hole and got the and-one contact and the foul on Lorenzo Martinez.
So Dott with the first points of the game for the Yuba 49ers. Sinks the free throw, completes the and one play. This is Solano's first opportunity in the half court with R.J. Lewis bringing the ball into the half court. Kicks it to Sell in the corner. Gets the screen from Martinez, and he shoots the three-point shot, but it is long. Rebounded by Eric Sheeve. Jordan Johnson bring the ball into the half court. They're setting into the post with Jahad Woods, kicking it out to Jordan Johnson. 15 on the shot clock. Dot thought about that corner three, but puts it into the post to Woods. Nice shovel pass in to Jalen Davis for two.
Yeah, Davis with the back cut. And Woods found him on the opposite side, giving him the open shot.
And so R.J. Lewis drives to his right, gets the contact, and good play by Jalen Davis to kind of hold R.J. Lewis so he doesn't try to get the and-one opportunity. But R.J. Lewis will go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, we've seen R.J. Lewis from last year. Very good three-point shooter. Can also drive to the hole, and he can create shots for others.
So actually that contact was before the shot opportunity, so they take the ball out of bounds. Lewis drives to his right, takes the contact, shoves it off to Martinez, makes a nice little pump move, and gets the hoop for two.
Yeah, R.J. Lewis finding him with the little space that he had, found Martinez, and Martinez almost didn't get a chance to get that shot up.
Lefty drive, no good by Davis, rebound by Lewis. He pushes it himself. Dot pokes the ball away. Yuba tries to save the ball by diving out of bounds right into the lap of Josh Redson, our very own Josh Redson. Taking stills over there on the baseline.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't take a picture of the guy sliding towards him.
Oh, come on, Josh. Action shots. Action shots. As Jazzik gets the inbound pass, Sell drives to his left, gathers and kicks it out to Bryant. He drives and kicks out to Lewis. Bryant maneuvering down the lane and throws up the layup. No good. Jahad Woods corrals the ball, brings it into the half court for Yuba.
Yeah, and one thing about Yuba is they're very lanky.
And Woods with the hook, no good. Tried to use that length over Martinez, but just couldn't get the friendly roll.
The basketball gods down loud.
As the foul will be on Jordan Johnson with a little hand check on Anthony Bryant. Bryant gets a nice screen from Martinez. Martinez has a mismatch if they can find it, but Lewis open for three, and he hits it.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to give R.J. Lewis wide open shots because he can hit those all day long.
A team leading 17 points per game for R.J. Lewis, really stepping up in his sophomore campaign. As that ball kind of thrown into nowhere, Jordan Johnson picks it up, shoots the three, no good. Martinez with the rebound. Bryant pushing on the counterattack. Drives to his left. Little floater, too hard off the backboard. Martinez couldn't clean it up. As Sell with a nice defense, but Yuba picks up the ball and settles things down in the half court. Tie ball game, 5-5. Dot with some pump fakes and nice moves, but cannot finish. Battle for the rebound. R.J. Lewis is on the deck as Johnson lines up a three. No good. Sell with the rebound.
Yeah, it's a great job by Solano playing good defense. You see the hustle from R.J. Lewis, but it almost cost him a wide-open three-point attempt.
There you saw briefly Chance Pippen sitting down at the scorer's table, set to check in as Sell in the corner for three, and it is short. Jazzik going for the rebound. Good hustle, but Yuba with Sheev with a little touch to save the ball in bounds. Approaching 16 minutes left in this first half. Tie ball game, 5-5. Jalen Davis brings the ball out.
Yeah, and I don't think Yuba was a good three-point team, shooting team last year. I don't know if things changed, as you see Dot with the three-point attempt. But maybe that could be an advantage for Solano as they try to contain them in the paint.
So Dot was 6 points of the eight that Yuba has scored. Jazzik swings it over to Bryant. Lewis open from the arc. Pump fake gets by Dot again with a shovel pass, but Lewis shuffled the feet for the travel call.
Yeah, just right before he made the pass, he kind of tiptoed that left foot down. If he could have kept that foot off the ground, Martinez has a wide open dunk.
Robert Jackson, number 21, and number 23, Chance Pippen, check in. They'll be your backcourt with Lewis sliding over to that small four position. Jazzik at the stretch four, and Martinez manning the middle at center. Errant pass stolen by Chance Pippen. He has a free lane, lays it up, and it is good.
Chance Pippen can definitely get out there. If he has a wide open lane, he's definitely going to take it.
Pippen is fourth on the team in scoring with 7.6 points per game, and those stats are in 11 of the 12, unfortunately for the statistics. One of Solano's games offensively and, of course, defensively with like rebounds and assists was not recorded, so in 11 of the 12, Pippen has shown the ability to put the ball in the hoop. And he started earlier in the year. I think Coach Nagel's really trying to figure out the right lineup to go with. He has a lot of opportunities with the depth that Solano offers. So this starting lineup of Bryant and Lewis in the backcourt is something new that we haven't seen so far.
Yeah, as a coach, you have to experiment with different things. Got to get what lineups you want in certain situations. Like, you might not want the starting lineup to be the lineup that finishes the game sometimes, like the L.A. Clippers. Mm-hmm. I know they have Jamal Crawford finish a lot of games. So it's just experimenting, like you said.
That man you saw in the middle of your screen, number 12, Lorenzo Martinez, has started in all 12 and now 13 games as the post move by Eric Sheeve is up and good as he used his length to get over the smaller Jazzik with a nice righty hook off the backboard.
Yeah, Jazzik isn't much of a shot blocker, but he can put a body on you.
Robert Jackson now pulls the ball out, gets it to Lewis at the top. Gets a screen from Martinez. Yuba players actually collide with each other. 8 seconds left. Steps into the three, does Lewis, and that ticks front iron and rebounded by Sheeve. Johnson for Yuba brings it into the half court. Swing the ball around to Davis. He shoots the three, and it is short. Rebound by Martinez.
Yeah, you didn't see Davis jump at all on that three-point attempt. He just stayed flat-footed.
That risky full-court pass to Chance Pippen was intercepted by Jordan Johnson. As ball into the post to Jihad Woods. Nice pump fake. Martinez bites, and he shoves it off to his teammate Sheeve for the deuce.
Yeah, if you're Martinez, you have to stay on the ground until the opponent leaves his feet to shoot the ball.
Yeah, that pump fake really opened up the spacing in the middle of the paint as Jazzik with the lefty three. That one is long and rebounded by Jalen Davis.
Yeah, he's going to hit one sooner or later.
Sheeve in the post. Backs down Jazzik with a nice again. He likes to go to his left, apparently, go over that left shoulder with the righty hook, as that seems to be the go-to move for Sheeve in the post.
Yeah, with Eric Sheeve, that post game and then the mid-range game is where he stays all the time. And last time they played Solano, he hit a lot of those shots.
So currently Yuba is doubling up Solano, 14-7. Lewis with the pull-up jumper, and it rattles out. Martinez with the offensive rebound. Pippen look for the three. No look to Jazzik for three, and he hits it just as Anthony predicted.
Yeah, I know my guy, man.
Oh, good defense by Robert Jackson, but not able to get away as that mid-range swing through by Sheeve is no good. But yeah, there is the move, counter move that you like to see out of your post players. He backed down Jazzik with the post moves, and there he kind of swung through to open up that mid-range, just couldn't hit it. As Martinez in the post, too strong, rebounded by Sheeve.
Yeah, if you're Martinez, you got to pass that one back out. You never want to really force anything down low because sometimes you won't get the call.
Especially that early in the shot clock. Mm-hmm. As there is a whistle on the floor. Offensive foul away from the ball as Jalen Davis was called for the foul. Yuba will make a whole bunch of substitutions with Donald Jackson, Brandon Ruaro, as well as Xavier Francois checking in for the 49ers. Pippen inbounding to Lewis. 14-10 game here. First game of 2017 for the Falcons. Coming in with a 6-6 record. 1-0 in conference play, coming off a win against Los Medanos as Jackson knocks down his defender, and that long rebound goes out to Travis Sell. No contact, no foul called on the contact, and Jackson heads up play calling timeout.
Yeah, good job by Jackson, because if he didn't call the timeout, then there would have been a jump ball, and I don't think they would have got possession.
Yeah, technically the possession era would be with them, but again, those hustle plays, and we'll check this replay out of the three by Dan Jazzik, and he nails it as the good half-court play from the Falcons that cut the seven-point lead down to four, which it is currently with 12:19 left in the first half. Anthony, your thoughts so far as we're getting down to the second half of the first half?
Well, Solano, they're doing a good job playing defense and containing this long Yuba team. As you can see, a lot of their players are over about 6'3", 6'4", And Solano, they aren't that tall. Martinez would be the tallest person on the team. But Solano, they can outrun you, which is a good skill to have.
Yeah, definitely the size will be one to watch, as there you can see the tall trees of the 49ers. Ready to check back in. Robert Jackson set to inbound. And Lewis gets it with 25 on the shot clock. Martinez ready to set the screen for Lewis, and Sell switches defenders with Lewis. Lewis picks up the dribble, passes it over to Pippen. 10 seconds left in the half court. We'll see what Solano has, as Lewis is going to dribble.
He's going to have to shoot this one.
Yeah, good defense from Yuba. They're going to get a shot clock violation. Just too much dribbling by R.J. Lewis and the Solano Falcons in that half court set.
Yeah, they couldn't really get the offense set up in time. And, you know, like you said, too much dribbling. The players aren't moving enough.
So Francois dribbles past Sell, gets the contact, and he gets it to go. And Francois is pumped.
Yeah, Francois definitely looked like the type of player that has a lot of energy, the heart and soul of a team, the person that just gets the team rallied up. And, you know, it's always good to have those type of players on your team.
Got the Anderson Verja hair working, does Francois, as the free throw is long. One-handed rebound by Martinez. Very important there to not get a second possession for Yuba.
Yeah, especially with the Solano Falcons going small at this point with Martinez at center. And Martinez has to stay out of foul trouble.
It's definitely going to be something to watch for, as Sell, who's basically playing that stretch four role, kicks it out to Pippen. He kicks it out to Sell. Sell with the pump fake. 5 seconds left. Back-to-back half-court sets. Not really the greatest ball movement. And credit Yuba's defense for really stifling that Falcons attack.
Yeah, and I remember 2 years ago for Solano, that was a big factor and a big problem they had about not moving the ball.
Ruaro getting pressured by Robert Jackson. Nice crossover. Pass it off to Francois. Francois with a little Euro step. Got a lot of distance on that one, and he lays it up and in.
Yeah, that's what happens when you're long and you're able to have the type of footwork of a guard. You know, kind of like Kevin Durant, you know, when he Euro steps, he takes long steps.
There, Jackson kicks it to Sell. Back up top to Lewis. And he dribbles, and pull-up jumper is good. So R.J. Lewis with the bucket cuts the deficit to 18-12.
Good shot by R.J. Lewis. He's gonna need to have a big game if Solano wants to come out with this win.
Francois looking to post up, get it into the post to Sheev, who has a size advantage over Travis Sell. Ruaro in the corner with 8 seconds left in the shot clock. Donald Jackson drives to his left. 3 seconds, 2-1. Johnson heaves the three, and the long rebound goes out to Francois with a nice post move. And Francois, 6 straight points for the Yuba 49ers.
Nice post move by Francois. He faked one way and took the hard dribble the other way. And that's how you want. That's what you want from a big man.
So Falcons looking to get things going in the half court, as with a nice little give and go, Sell with the layup and the foul.
That's a good job from Sell. Having the focus to finish off that play.
And a great lead pass by Robert Jackson really led Sell straight to the bucket, and Sell with a great opportunity for the three-point play, as Solano makes some moves. Vaughn Davis checking in, as well as Dan Jazik checking back into the ball game, and Anthony Bryant as well.
Yeah, they must be looking to spread the floor a little bit more.
Yeah, Jazik and Sell both can hit the three from those big positions, and maybe that spacing will help that half-court offense a little bit, as Woods in the post kicks it back out. Size advantage over Sell, and he tried to dish it off to Francois, and that ball's going to stay Yuba ball. And Coach Nagel getting on Anthony Bryant, who just let that ball go. He should have maybe had the awareness to realize that that was off a Solano player. That could have easily been a Solano ball. But Yuba gets a second possession, as Thomas Ostefjord in the corner, trying to post, get it into the post to Woods. Nice lefty drive, and Donald Jackson with the lefty layup.
Yeah, it's great drive by Jackson with time running down. Good awareness to take it in for the hoop.
So that brings the score 22-14 with 8:53 and counting. Jazik kicks it to the corner to Pippen, who has a lane. He tried to dump it off to Sell, but good defense to get in the passing lane by Yuba. Ruaro bringing it into the half court. Being D'd up by Vaughn Davis. Kicks it over to Donald Jackson. Francois with a hot hand. Kicks it cross court to Ruaro for three, and he hits it.
Yeah, Ruaro is definitely the smallest player on Yuba. But with that three-pointer right there, you can see that Yuba's big player, big man, definitely have court vision.
8:15 and counting. Chance Pippen for three, and he hits it. So Pippen responds with a three-point from Ruaro with a three of his own.
Yes, now they have to play defense.
Ostafjord bowls over Pippen. Ruaro tees up another three, and it's good. Mm. So Ruaro stretching the court.
Yeah, back-to-back-to-back three-point shots. That's what you want to see. The tempo of this game is definitely picking up.
I know it's not February. It's not All-Star Weekend yet. So I don't know why this three-point contest is breaking out here at Solano Community College. As Vaughn Davis dribbles to his right, 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Pippen thought about the three, dribbles out to Anthony Bryant, who drives to his left, gets all the way to the bucket, and in with the lefty scoop.
Yes, nice left-handed shot by Bryant.
7:30 left in this first half. Yuba is leading by 9 points as a foul away from the ball is called on Anthony Bryant. That'll get R.J. Lewis and Lorenzo Martinez back into the ballgame. Probably two of the more consistent players. As the replay, you see Bryant gets all the way to the hole past Donald Jackson and lays it up and in for the deuce. As Eric Sheave checking in for Francois, who provided a lot of good minutes in a short amount of time in that first half. Scored a lot of points in the post for Yuba.
Yes, and Bryant and Woods getting into a little scuffle. The ref warning them right now.
As Yuba inbounding the ball. Close to a five-second call, and Ruaro gets it after Bryant almost got his fingertips on that. 25 on the shot clock. As you see Donald Jackson trying to get it up top to Jahad Woods. He drives the lane, gets all the way to the bucket, takes the contact, flips it up, and no good, but he will get two free throws as he draws a foul from Dan Jazik.
And if you're Davis, you can't gamble on that type of play because it left Woods with a wide open lane to the hoop. You know, Woods can definitely get up.
So, Jahad Woods at the line. Ready to shoot two. The sophomore out of Vanden, local kid, 6'8", 215.
Man, I would love to be 6'8".
First free throw is good. Jahad Woods. That's going to be an impressive battle between Woods and Martinez. Expect when Woods checks in, Martinez will probably check back in the ballgame because Martinez really is the best size to match up with a guy like Woods. As he hits both free throws, extends the lead to 11. 49ers are leading 30-19. Martinez gets an inbound as Yuba with the full court pressure. Not the most intense full court pressure you'll ever see as Bryant blows by Ruaro, gets to the hole and is fouled by Ostafjord. So Bryant, with the ability to drive to the bucket, will get an opportunity to shoot two free throws.
That's good job by Bryant taking his opponent off the dribble, going to the hoop, and also a nice job by Ostafjord by not allowing any easy baskets.
Guard out of Fairfield High hits the first free throw. And interesting so far in this first half, the rotation for Coach Nagel and the Falcons. We haven't seen Sean Gray, who is one of the leading scorers for Solano, the second leading scorer at 8.7 points per game, as well as Steven Jefferson, who's 7.5 points per game, is fifth on the team. So interesting rotation as Ruaro tees up his third three of the half in the little man. getting hot from long distance.
Hey, little man, big heart. He's definitely somebody you have to look out for tonight. He's going to keep hitting those three-point shots.
Yeah, when you're the shortest man on the court, you got to have some ability to really stay on the court. And Lewis kicks out to the corner to Jazik. Big man for three is too long. Ossefjord lets it go out of bounds, and it'll be Yuba ball.
Yeah, that shot was kind of rushed by Solano. They didn't really get their feet set or run any play. You have to run plays against this Yuba squad because they're so long. And if you just throw up any shot, then they're going to possibly block it or force you to take a bad shot.
So Yuba's Twin Towers are in there with Woods and Sheev as Jackson out to Ruaro for three. And it is off to the left. Good hustle by Ossefjord to get that offensive rebound. And Lorenzo Martinez with the hand check to Ruaro.
Yeah, if you're Martinez, you can't hand check any smaller players because you have the height advantage. They might be quick, but you can easily recover. And also, you're the tallest player on this team, so you have to stay in the game.
And Josh Dott and Jordan Johnson, two of the starters for Yuba, checking in for Ossefjord and Donald Jackson as Dott D'd up by Sell. Setting the half court, trying to get it to Sheev in the post. He sealed off really nicely, Jazik, but that hook was too strong. Bryant on the fast break the other way, takes the contact and will go to the line yet again to shoot two.
Yes, Bryant getting to the hole at will. If he could keep getting to the free throw line, he can have a big game tonight.
So Anthony Bryant set to shoot two free throws for the Falcons. Down 13 here with 5:40 left in the first half. Rattles home the first one. And I'll get Joe Reddish into the ballgame for the Yuba 49ers, rocking the man bun.
Yeah, I wish I could rock a man bun. You know, try and switch it up a little bit.
As Bryant hits that second one. 33-22, Yuba leads. I just wish I had hair, man. Josh Dott out to Reddish. Drives to his right, past Bryant, kicks it out to Sheev. Woods back up top to Ruaro. Little mishandled by Ruaro. 8 seconds left. Reddish drives, little floater, and it is too short. As Jazik with a nice outlet pass to Bryant. They have numbers if they push. Out to Sell in the corner for three, and he hits it.
Yeah, I've seen Sell and Chance Pippen warming up today, and Sell was nonstop from the three-point line.
Yeah, Sell really that stretch four for the Falcons, playing the three position as Lewis tipped the ball out of bounds. As Chance Pippen, the aforementioned Pippen, checks back in the ballgame, as well as Xavier Francois, who provided really good minutes for Yuba, checking in for Sheev.
Yeah, and if I'm Yuba, I'm going to give it to Francois down low because you're going to have either Jazik or Sell guarding you.
Reddish for three. That one is offline. But, again, Francois on the offensive boards with the post move, and that's going to be an offensive foul with the arm hook. Good call by the referee, seeing that he sealed off, I believe it was either Jazik or Sell in the post and tried to get that post move, but he hooked him with the off arm.
Yeah, it was Jazik. But that's one thing about Jazik that he has the upper hand on Francois on is the size.
Mm-hmm. Hard body to move around as Dott going to be called for the foul, I believe.
Oh, yeah, trust me. I know how hard it is to move that big body.
As Jazik will inbound to Bryant or Lewis. Kicks it into Lewis. 15 on the shot clock as Jazik gets the ball. In the corner, Woods hounding him. Sell in the post. Francois with the nice hands pokes it away from Sell. Sell with the
nice
up and under.
Nice.
How in the world did he get that in?
Hey, sometimes you just know the backboard. And he put the right spin on the shot. Easy hoop.
Offensive foul on Yuba. And suddenly the Falcons have some momentum. After being down double digits, the Falcons have cut the lead 33-27. So just down six with 4 minutes remaining in this first half. We'll get that scoreboard corrected. 33-27 is your score. as Pippen gets the ball in the half court, drives past Ruaro, kicks it out to Lewis. He'll reset with 10 seconds left. Pippen in the corner has the size advantage over Ruaro. 5 seconds. Pippen gonna have to shoot, and Woods strips it from Chance Pippen. Good open, open court, and Pippen fouls Jihad Woods on the alley-oop attempt.
Yeah, that was kind of dangerous from Woods. I didn't know if they should go for the alley-oop on that one. He was running too fast.
And it was too late.
It was too late. Yeah, he could have broken his arm or something.
Yeah, he definitely could have gotten his hand, like, on the backboard before he tried to, like, kind of cock it back and slam it home. Fortunate for Yuba that Jihad Woods is all right. Going to shoot 2 free throws here.
Yeah, but he did get up on the alley-oop.
Oh, he got a hand on it.
Yeah.
Which is very impressive. As Eric Sheeve is set to check in for Yuba after this free throw, unless he is going in for the shooter. That one is long for Woods, as Sheeve will check in for Xavier Francois. Really, Francois, Dot, Ruaro have gotten the 49ers on nice little runs here. Really a well-balanced attack for Yuba to get this 6-point lead. It is now 7 as Robert Jackson checks in for Solano and for Chance Pippen. Not sure how the Falcons lost a point there. Scores 34-27. With 3:20 approaching in this half. Sell with the post moves, trying to get up and under Woods, but Woods with the discipline to stay down. But with the heads up play by RJ Lewis, he gets the bucket.
Nice awareness by RJ Lewis. And you've seen he didn't come down with the shot because it would have took too much time.
Redis drives the hole and gets the lefty layup to answer. Lead back up to 7-4, Yuba. 2:50 and counting. Left in this first half. Jackson drives to his left. Doc got a hand on the ball, but Jackson kept going, and he gets the friendly roll. Nice little English on that shot.
Yeah, it was some English, Spanish, French, all type of language on that shot.
And RJ Lewis with the heads-up play. They've been feeding those post plays, and that's the kind of aggression you like to see. Lewis drives to his left, kicks it out to Jackson for the long-range shot. That one is short, and Bryant is going to be called for a foul away from the ball.
Yeah, I thought Jackson should have swung it one more time to Jezik, because the defender was running towards for the closeout at so Jackson.
Actually, Bryant wasn't called for the foul. It was actually Ruaro on Bryant, and Yuba is in the single bonus, so shooting 1-1 will be Anthony Bryant. As going to the bench is Josh Dott, replaced by Donald Jackson.
Yeah, Anthony Bryant, a good free throw shooter.
Going to have to hit this first one, and he does. Big points. That's the kind of thing you need in a comeback event, is to nail your free throws, because no time comes off the clock, and you get those points on the board, as he is short on that second one. Gets 1 of 2. 4-point lead now for Yuba as Ruaro brings it into the half court. Travel called. So Yuba making some mistakes now in the half court, really causing a lot of turnovers. Solano, that's one thing that they haven't done, is turn the ball over. Good ball control so far for the Solano offense. It's just a matter of getting that rhythm in the half court that they need to really fix in order to get back in this game.
Yes, because once they get their rhythm and the three-point shots start to fall, there's no stopping this team.
Lewis broke away from Reddish, and he drives all the way to the hole, and Sheev's size really made Lewis alter that shot, and a little slick spot made Lewis trip there. So Yuba has numbers. Ruaro with the long three. That one is shot long and rebounded to Joe Reddish.
Yeah, I know. I know he wishes he could have that shot back because he was wide open.
And that's the thing about long shots, it's long rebounds. So good heads up by Yuba to get that long rebound. As Sheeve in the post, Sell doesn't buy on the up fake, and nice putback dunk by Jahad Woods.
Yeah, I knew he wanted that one. As soon as he seen it come off the rebound, off the rim, he wanted that shot.
So minute 30 left in this half. Falcons looking to cut into the six-point deficit. As Jazzik gives the screen to Lewis. Jackson now working on the opposite side with Joe Resch. Crosses him up. Kicks it to Sell. That one is way off target and is going to glance off of Chance Pippen out of bounds.
Yeah, and if you're Chance Pippen, you have to secure that rebound over Araru because he can't guard you in the post or anywhere down low. That's an easy basket for him.
So Yuba will get the ball here with 1:10 left in this first half, up six. RJ Lewis and the Falcons trail. They've trailed for most of this first half, but I've gotten nice little spurts of momentum here in this first half to keep it a close game against a tough team in Yuba. As Sheev gets hounded by the Falcons, Reddish tried to force that one into Sheev, and that goes off of a Falcons defender out of bounds.
That was a bad decision by Reddish. He had the wide-open shot in the lane. So
just kind of shows the confidence of Reddish, or lack thereof, in his shot. As Jahad Woods with the nice cut and rises above all the Falcons defenders to put that one in for two.
Yeah, Woods is one person I don't want to see come down the lane if I'm Solano.
So we'll see if Solano tries to go quick 2-for-1, as again, something wrong with the tires of RJ Lewis as he slips yet again.
Yeah, because I think the last time he hit the ground, he actually fell again after that when nobody was around him. So maybe no grip in his shoes, maybe, you know, a West Bubblem floor.
He's got to get some new kicks from the Falcons. Ruaru gets it into the post to Sheev. Nice entry pass. Jazzik with the foul.
Yeah, good job by Jazzik fouling him. You don't want to allow any easy baskets down low, especially to Eric Sheev. You just have to make sure he doesn't get the continuous shot and the foul.
And it's important for these minutes with Jazzik and Sell at the big position to give Martinez this last 27 seconds off for this first half so he doesn't pick up a foul, get into any sort of foul trouble. I believe he only has one foul to this point in this first half. So giving him four fouls really gets him into more aggressive position defensively, and that could really help the Falcons in the half court when they're trying to defend these tall 6'8", 6'10", Yuba players like Sheev and Woods. As he hits both free throws, RJ Lewis checking back into the ball game for this last 27 seconds, so you got to believe, unless Yuba creates a turnover with this full court press that they're about to implement. But no, they're going to back off. This will probably be the last shot for the Falcons, or either side for that matter. 15 seconds left in this first half. Anthony Bryant out to RJ Lewis. Gets a screen from Jazzik. Step back three by RJ Lewis in his eye. 4 seconds left. Ruaru circling the defense. Shoots a long three, and it is just off to the right. So RJ Lewis with the big bucket. Just have a laugh at the negative 158 left in the first half. Don't believe that, folks. His first half is over. 49ers lead 42-35. Your thoughts on the first half, Anthony?
Solano did a great job by containing Yuba. Yuba, like I said earlier, they have the length, but they don't really have very good three-point shooters. Well, at least from the taller people. Woods likes to get to the hole. Sheev likes the mid-range game. But Solano is doing a good job, and RJ Lewis is continuing to prove why he's the leader of this team.
Yeah, and I like from Solano that they're not really forcing anything. You see a lot of hero ball sometimes from the Falcons in the past, but this team is really has a good team chemistry to their half-court set. And in the defensive side of the things, they force a lot of Yuba turnovers defensively, a lot of steals. They've gotten forced a lot of traveling calls on Yuba. So Solano's defense has done pretty well. They kept it under 10 points against a tough 49ers team. So they're well within striking distance here at home. So when we come back, folks, we will have the second half for you between the Yuba 49ers and the Solano Falcons right here on the Solano College Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Melanie Fuller with the Solano College Sports Network, here with your Best Buy player of the game, Chance Pippen, and I want to be the next household name for in-game reporting. If you have an interest in a career in sports broadcasting, whether it be behind the scenes or in front of the camera,
then this is the program for you.
Hi, my name is Anthony Williams, and I want to be a sports analyst, video editor, journalist, producer, and graphic designer.
Hi, I'm Tyra Mott. I want to be an actor, but for now, I'm paying my dues behind the camera. For more information,
contact Greg Poff. That's me at solano.edu.
Hey guys, my name is Tiana Wilson, and I hope to be the next TV talk show host or work behind the scenes as a producer. Remember, be the change you want to see. It starts with you. On behalf of myself, Greg Poff, and the students of COM 75 A and B and COM 80 A and B, we thank you for supporting the Solano College Sports Network, your number one source for local sports. And remember,
it's more than just basketball.
It's more than just baseball.
It's more than just sports. It's an education.
And welcome back, folks, to the second half of this ball game. Yuba 49ers up 42-35 over the Solano Falcons. Anthony, really, second halves are all about adjustments. Coach John Nagel for the Solano Falcons, Coach Doug Cornelius for the Yuba 49ers. What do both teams have to do in order to kind of make those adjustments?
If I'm Solano, then I'm definitely trying to keep Jahad Woods out the paint because he's getting there at will. And if I'm Yuba, I'm just trying to contain R.J. Lewis for right now because they're doing a good job with the rest of the Solano Falcons.
And Lewis with a nice pump fake out to Jazik for three. That one just rattles out, but good offensive rebound by Lorenzo Martinez, and he is fouled by Jahad Woods. So maybe that's the way to get Woods out of the game too, is you pound the paint, maybe getting him into foul trouble. But he didn't really get any fouls in the first half.
Yeah, but one thing about Lorenzo Martinez is he doesn't really have the post moves to get Woods into foul trouble. Like, he's more of a get into your body and finish over the top of you. And with Woods being long, he could kind of defend that. But, you know, if Martinez could find a way to get Woods in trouble.
Or even with RJ and Anthony Bryant showed his ability to drive very well in that first half. Maybe those smaller players can get into the body of Woods as Martinez rattles out the second one as well. So 0-for-2, missed opportunity by Martinez to get the first points of the second half down for the Falcons.
Yeah, and you need free throws.
Jordan Johnson spots up for three, and that one is off to the right of the rim. Good outlet pass. Anthony Bryant wide open. And R.J. Lewis with a nice cross-court assist.
Yes, good job by Anthony Bryant by finishing, because Jalen Davis was coming and tried to scare him, but he kept his composure and finished.
Jahad Woods behind the back. Jazik with the nice hands to try and strip Woods. And R.J. Lewis with a nice steal brings it up court. But he telegraphed that pass. Dot just knocked it out of bounds. Lucky Dot didn't pick that one off and go the other way for Yuba.
Yes, good, but good job by Solano because they kept Woods from getting the ball. And good job by protecting the paint.
So good defense to start out with by Solano as Jazik gets the inbound, shovels it off. Sell open in the corner, pump fake, drives past Davis, shovels it off to Martinez, and he lost control of the ball, but luckily he gets a contact from Woods, picks up two quick fouls, does Jahad Woods.
Yeah, silly foul by Woods because he didn't really need to foul Martinez. Like you say, he lost control of the ball.
So Martinez will look to do better than his last attempt at 0-for-2 from the free throw line. Takes a big breath in. That one rattles out. Gotta wonder if that's in the psyche of the big man, as the really a good X factor Xavier Francois checks in for Jahad Woods. Francois is going to be somebody difficult that the Falcons have to match up with.
Yeah, Francois is definitely energy, straight energy, and he's very physical.
And Martinez misses the free throw yet again, 0-for-4. Don't want to see a hack-a-zo Hackalorenzo. As a foul away from the ball, as a little pile up, as Dot gets fouled, crashes into Anthony Bryant. A little levity there here at Solano Community College. Is that inbound to Francois, cross court to Johnson. He has a wide open lane, but good by Martinez to alter that shot with his length, but Johnson comes out of the pack with the offensive rebound. Yuba will reset. Jordan Johnson is your point guard with Jalen Davis in the backcourt. Francois, Dot, and Sheev are your bigs as Yuba with a nice layup.
Yeah, nice left-hand layup by Jalen Davis, getting to the hole and finishing around Dan Jezik.
Brian and RJ Lewis are your backcourt. Travis Sell in with Dan Jezik and Lorenzo Martinez for the Falcons. The starting lineup, of course, back in for the start of the second half as a turnover by the Falcons. A rarity, really, from the first half where they took really good possession of the ball. Spots up three for Davis, but kind of a long line drive. Kicks out to Francois. Nice body control to lay that one up and in from Francois.
Jalen Davis' shot is so flat-footed. it's like you can see where the line drive comes from.
It looks a little like Justice Winslow's jump shot. As Jazik out to the corner for Lewis for three. He jumps with 2 feet, and he hits the three-point shot.
Well, you just can't leave RJ Lewis alone.
Leading scorer for the Falcons, trying to lead a comeback here in the second half. Down by six, 17-13 left in this second half. As Francois gets it in the post, Martinez, good length. They kick it back out to Jordan Johnson. 10 on the shot clock for Yuba to work with. They're trying to get it back in the post to Francois. Dot squares up for three, and it is good. So Yuba suddenly getting hot from distance. It's a couple three-pointers here in this second half.
Yeah, Dot hitting his second three-point shot of the game. Really spreading the floor out for Yuba.
And 9 points for Dot as Lewis lucky to get that ball back. Squared up for the three. Oh, Josh Dot really tripped up intentionally RJ Lewis, and he is down on the deck. Yeah, that one was not your basketball play as RJ looked to cut. Dot just reached up and blatantly tripped him.
Yeah.
So there you see in the left-hand corner of that replay, Dot reached up to trip RJ Lewis. Not sure if there's an intentional foul or a flagrant foul that could be called there, but that wasn't really a basketball play.
It could be a technical foul. I mean, like you said, it wasn't a basketball play. There was no reason for him to do it. Like, you're trying to stop a man from getting a wide open cut. I mean, come on. Like, there's way more stuff, way more worse stuff that could happen during the game.
And luckily, RJ Lewis is fine. And as the referees discuss what will happen, I think they're kind of questioning whether that will be, what type of foul that will be, whether it's just a straight up personal foul or if it should be something more egregious.
Yeah. And also, you never want a player to hit the floor, because these floors are very hard, and I've experienced a lot of pain from hitting these floors.
And so they will call some sort of either flagrant or intentional foul as RJ Lewis is going to the line, nobody around him, so he'll get 2 shots and the ball. Nails the first one. Confident stroke from Lewis, but that one rattles out.
Yeah, he didn't really take his time with the second shot, and that's probably why he missed it.
Yeah, a little rush there as Yuba makes a couple substitutions. Donald Jackson and Brandon Ruaro, who was red hot from outside. 3 three-pointers in that first half for Yuba. As the inbound play is to Chance Pippen, who just checked in the game. That one is an air ball, though. Left that one way too short. As Jordan Johnson checks in. Yuba going small as, oh, great hang time by Donald Jackson. Gets the bucket to go and the foul.
Yeah, he had a better option of going with the reverse on that shot, but nice finish ability.
And that one just hung up on the rim just enough and sank in for Donald Jackson, the reserve guard for Yuba. like I said, Ruaro, Johnson, and Jackson in there. Kind of a small look for Yuba to join the big 6'10 Sheev as well as Xavier Francois. Bryant bringing the ball up court. Nobody really checking him. Lewis in the corner. That one is short, but long rebound out to Martinez. Bryant drives, stops, looks to kick to an open teammate. Lewis drives. That one is kicked out to Chance Pippen. They're going to settle things down here at 20 seconds left in the shot clock. Lewis in the corner, down to the post to Martinez. Looks to make a move on Sheev. Nice baby hook and good rhythm there. Gets a couple rhythm dribbles. Nice right hook from Martinez.
Yes, good job by Martinez. He knew what he wanted to do as soon as he got the ball in the post.
And that hook, not even the big 6'10 Sheev could get a fingertip on that one as Falcons cut the deficit down to 8. Jordan Johnson lines up a 3. He nails his second 3-point shot of the second half.
It's a great job by Johnson retaliating with the 3-point shot, keeping Solano within from coming back in this game.
Yeah, extends lead to double digits as Lewis with a wide open pull-up jumper, and he nails it. Yes. RJ Lewis.
But RJ saying, no, we're coming back in this game.
Ruaro, the diminutive point guard, into the post of the big 6'10 Sheev. I like to see them standing next to each other in the team photo. 6'10 Sheev next to Ruaro.
I couldn't imagine standing next to Sheev.
I mean, he doesn't even get up to the top of the 11 on Sheev's number on his jersey.
Yeah, kind of like the Spud Webb and Munot Bowl photo.
Nobody installs Munot Bowl. Now 6'10 Sheev as Jackson out to Ruaro, open for 3. That one is too long. Good outlet pass by Bryant. Pippen in the corner. Little pump fake. Keeps his foot down. Nice little bank shot, but just didn't get the right angle. Shot a little too strong off the backboard, did Chance Pippen.
Yeah, but it was a good shot by Pippen because Ruaro can't guard him down low.
Jackson lines up a 3, and that one takes off iron. Lewis with the rebound. He is going to try and split the defense, but it goes off of the leg of a couple of Yuba defenders. Bryant picks it up. He drives. He's driving the lane, trying to look for a teammate. A little out of control by the Falcons, and they kick it out to Lewis to kind of settle things down with 15 on the shot clock.
Yes, good job by RJ by slowing things down because it was kind of crazy. But now they have 5 seconds to get a shot off.
RJ has to be aware of that. 3 seconds left. Good defense. Yuba steals the ball away. Ruaro kind of settle things down in the corner with RJ Lewis dinging him up. Nice little kick save out of bounds. Trying to deny that entry pass to Sheev as Jordan Moss will get his first playing time for the Falcons along with Robert Jackson and Dan Jazik. Jordan Moss really built like a football player out there.
Yeah.
A little bowling ball.
Like, he has that Raymond Felton body. You know, big for a point guard, but very quick.
As Moss D's up Ruaro, Jackson has the advantage over the big man Martinez at 6'6". Surprised Jackson doesn't try to drive by him, but he picked up his dribble. Doesn't have a live dribble. 3 seconds left. Jordan Johnson for 3. Can't bail him out. Long rebound out to Jordan Moss.
Yeah, and if you're a Jackson, you have to take the opportunity to take a center to the hole.
RJ Lewis in the corner. Offensive foul. Great movement by Donald Jackson to move his feet to stay in front of RJ Lewis. That's the only way you get that offensive foul call is if you move your feet and stay in front of that offensive player. Otherwise, it's a block.
Yeah.
So Ruaro bring the ball up after the nice defensive play and turnover from the Falcons. And there's going to be a timeout by Yuba. Coach Doug Cornelius going to call timeout here with 12:54 left in the second half. 9-point game, 49ers able to extend their halftime lead by 2 points. Again, back and forth. I think this is going to be a close contest from here on out for both sides.
Yeah, and that's a good thing for us because we love close games. But it would be interesting to see how Solano comes back and possibly gets the victory tonight.
Yeah, definitely give kudos to RJ Lewis. Really a name you call very often for the Falcons offense. such a consistent shooter, can pull up from mid-range off the dribble. He's a spot-up three-point shooter, and he can get to the hole and pass to his teammates as well. So really, a lot of superlatives to really describe R.J. Lewis's game, just a very good all-around player and good leader for the Falcons. It's going to be very important for this last 12:50 and counting, as Ruwaru trying to get it into Sheave as Jazzik fronts Sheave. Jackson out to Sheave. 8 seconds left. Francois on the post has Martinez on him. Martinez stays down nicely, altered that shot, but Sheave with the size tips it up and in for the deuce. RJ Lewis being D'd up by Jackson, blows by him. Francois with a nice hand zone, picks his pocket.
Yes, Francois with a nice pick on RJ. That's just the many things he can do. He could really irritate you on defense, but also hustle on the offensive end.
Sheave with the power move, but that hook is too strong off the back iron. Lewis on the counterattack, tries to go up with the left hand, and he is fouled by Donald Jackson. We'll go line shoot two.
Yeah, Jackson knew he got him a little bit on the shot attempt. That's why he tried to pick him up. Mm-hmm.
Good sportsmanship from Donald Jackson as RJ Lewis will go to the line, shoot two free throws. Really doesn't take his time. And Anthony Bryant is set to check in for RJ Lewis. Yeah. Should RJ make the second of two free throws?
Yeah, my free throw routine takes about like 5 to 6 seconds. So.
You're one of those pace play players where NBA wants you to hurry up and take the free throw. Anthony's just taking his sweet time. It's kind of like you're broadcasting. It's just you take your sweet time. You don't rush things. Just kind of say it like it is. But hey, you make it, right?
Yeah.
10-point ball game as Yuba leads the Solano Falcons 56-46. Sheave in the post, double team by Martinez and Jazzik. Jackson goes all the way to the hole and lays it up and in.
Yeah, Jackson loves that baseline because most of the shots he's finished have come from the baseline, and he also likes to get to the hole.
Anthony Bryant, who checked in for RJ Lewis, did a nice job of keeping his footing down. Almost a Harrison Barnes moment.
Yeah, I could imagine Nagel's face if he would have shot that three-point shot.
Moss with a nice crossover, and he's fouled. Jordan Moss going to the free throw line after the hard move to the bucket. There you see Moss up close, 11-10. Left in the second half, trying to cut this lead back down to 10 points with these two free throws. That one is left short. So the Falcons leaving points at the line really could benefit from those hoops going in. And, of course, you're watching the Solano College Sports Network with our main cameraman, Ty Ramont, as well as Soa Balazi, Josh Kinder on the cameras, Elizabeth Torres right there, her shot down the center of Jordan Moss, and of course Greg Poff producing. I'd like to thank our crew as always, and McKenna Guerrero on scoreboard. Moss missed both free throws, so at least six misses, or actually eight, because RJ missed two, Moss missed two, Lorenzo missed four, and Lorenzo commits the foul there against Yuba. So this free throw disparity, if they can start making the free throws, this lead could grow for Yuba.
Yeah, because if Solano capitalizes on their free throws, they could be well within 5.54 points. No, you always need to hit your free throws because they can dictate the way a game is played.
Woods hits his first as Travis Sell checks in for Dan Jazzik.
Yeah, and I believe that last foul was on Martinez.
Mm-hmm.
So now he has three fouls.
He's going to have to be very careful here on out. As Woods hits both free throws, going to cause a timeout to be called. So full team timeout from Solano. Score is 60-46, 49ers lead. You're watching the Solano College Sports Network, and of course, we'll pause for a little station identification. You're watching the Solano College Sports Network. My name is Brian Nelson here with Anthony Williams. You can watch all of our content on the Fairfield Cable Access Channel 28 if you live in the area, facebook.com/Solano College Sports Network, as well as YouTube. You can search Solano College Sports Network. Solano.edu/athletics will display some of our content, as well as Instagram at SCSN Sports, as well as Twitter at SCSN Sports, and our in-developing website, SolanoSportsNetwork.net. So a lot of ways to view our content, Anthony. What's your favorite way to view our content?
Mine would have to be Facebook, honestly, because if you're on social media, then Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, those are all your best options, mm-hmm. because you're going to want to check the page out every chance you get, see what's new, what we're doing in the classroom, you know.
Yeah, and if you check out some of our old stuff, you can see the men's team had a great win. I believe, did we cover the men's win or the women's win in their tournament? I believe it was the men's the second day.
I can't remember.
There's so much content, folks, I can't even keep it straight. But there's definitely great men's and women's basketball action, as well as upcoming baseball and softball. So this spring semester should be exciting, filled with a lot of entertaining games for the Solano Falcons as Martinez drives to his right, tries to go up and under, but Jihad Woods swats that ball out of there.
Yeah, with the 6'8 Woods, you can't really do any up and unders around him.
And nice mid-range pull-up by Donald Jackson, who's really put his mark on the second half. Relatively quiet off the bench in the first, but kind of feeling that role Ruaru did, scoring in a multitude of ways.
Yeah, and now Yuba is putting pressure on Solano, trying to force some more turnovers.
And a little jawing back and forth between Anthony Bryant and Donald Jackson. RJ Lewis checking in for Robert Jackson, as well as Dan Jazik in for Martinez. Probably be Martinez's longest break left in this game, with 10 minutes, 15 seconds left. If he comes back in, probably going to stay the rest of the game, should Woods and Sheev try to counteract that size. As the shot clock has failed to start, so kind of a benefit for the Solano Falcons. As Jazik spots up for three, that one is short. Long rebound to Sell, though. He gets it out to Lewis, and he's fouled by Jordan Johnson.
Yeah, just too much body by Johnson on that play. He kind of forced RJ too much out of bounds, and the ref was on it right away.
And so that sets up the one-on-one situation, as that is the seventh team foul. So the next three team fouls will be one-on-one situations, unless they're obviously a shooting foul. Lewis sinks that first one, which is necessary in a one-on-one. Of course, if you're new to basketball and college style one-on-ones, if you miss the first one, you don't get a second one. It's a live ball. But if you make the first one, you get a second free throw. He makes both, cuts the lead to 62-48. 14-point lead for Yuba here with just about 10 minutes remaining in the second half. Gets it into the post to Woods against the shorter Sell. Lewis goes to double team and kicks it back out to Donald Jackson. 6 seconds left. And that is going to reset the shot clock because that was a kickball from RJ Lewis. Now checking into the game, I mentioned it in the first half, Sean Gray, as a man who has yet to play in this game, checking in with 10 minutes left, was the second leading scorer at 8.7, just getting into the game now. So yeah. We'll see if that can provide some energy off the bench.
Yeah, they're trying to give Anthony Bryant a break because he definitely deserves it. He had a good first half, and they need him for the second half.
Yeah, pretty quiet second half for Brian after he got to the rim a couple of different times. And I think Lewis wants to get a men's soccer team started because that's the third kickball he's had.
Yeah, I think he's trying to tell the athletic director something, you know, trying to raise some money.
I know Eric Visser's around. He's trying to be like, you know, I know there's women's soccer, but, you know, there could be a men's soccer team started by RJ Lewis. Or maybe he wants to play hockey. Who knows? As Woods kicks it out to George Johnson, 4-3. That's a beautiful play in the half court by the 49ers.
Yeah, that's Johnson's third three-pointer of the game.
And that pass from Woods just straight into the pocket of Jordan Johnson as Lewis with a nice up fake. tries to get a back cutting. Lewis was Jazzik, but he threw it right into the Yuba defender's arms.
Yeah, smart play by Jazzik, but Lewis wasn't looking right away, and it forced Jazzik to hold on to the ball a little longer.
And that split second is all you need to lose the timing of that back cut and have the defender be able to catch up and get a hand on that ball.
Especially with the long arms of this Yuba team.
And Jazzik's doing a nice job of fronting Woods on that possession. 5 seconds left. Ruaru passes it to Johnson. He pulls up. He does a nice job of following his own shot, but Lewis with a nice rebound dribbles past a couple Yuba defenders, goes all the way to the bucket, and it's no call on that drive attempt. Jordan Johnson's going to pull the ball out. Yuba has numbers if they hurry. Jalen Davis to his left, and he's going to be fouled by Travis Sell.
Yeah, I don't know how they called that foul, but didn't call one for RJ Lewis.
Yeah, interesting refereeing there on that possession. But obviously they're closer to the court than we are, so give them the benefit of the doubt.
Their eyes could be bad.
So two free throws for the lefty Jalen Davis. Relatively quiet game for Davis. Hasn't done much. Misses that first free throw as Josh Dott and Thomas Ostafjord checking in for the really good tandem of Donald Jackson and Brandon Ruaru. Really provided a real good spark for the 49ers. Have about 15 points between the two of them off the bench, and that's something that's really valuable here. And a 17-point ball game as he hits the second one. So Yuba going on a nice run here. Lead by 18 with 8:30 and counting left in the second half. RJ Lewis trying to call for the play as Jordan Moss looks to go one-on-one against Ostafjord. Goes straight to the bucket, lays it up and in. One for Jordan Moss.
Nice finish by Jordan Moss, getting to the hole and finishing with the high layup.
Yeah, I think he liked that matchup of Ostafjord on him one-on-one because he looked directly at his defender, didn't look to try and pass someone at all. He had a one-track mind to get to the hole, and he got there. Nails the free throw. 66-51 is your score. Important to get a defensive stop here if you're Solano to get back in this ball game. As Dott, nice job getting the passing lane. Was RJ Lewis. Throws it off a Yuba defender. Travis Sell comes up with it. Passes it to Martinez. Great job by Ostafjord to give ground, but when Ostafjord was out of bounds, the ball hit him. So lucky break for Solano. It'll stay Falcon ball.
Yeah, that was a good job by Ostafjord by not jumping with Martinez. Because, you know, with a guy 6'6", 6'8", mm-hmm. coming at you, you never want to jump. But, yeah, good job by him.
Sean Gray gets the inbound pass, drives to his left, and he is swatted away by Jihad Woods. Josh Dott squares up for three, and he is long. Travis Sell with a strong rebound. Jordan Moss bringing it into the half court. Sean Gray now. 20 seconds, gets it over to RJ Lewis. That ball hit the end line, but that was after it was deflected off of Dott. So Ruaru, the backup point guard, checking back in for Josh Dott. .17 on the shot clock with 7:21 left in the ball game. Travis Sell with a nice pick and roll. Jordan Moss drives high off the backboard, and he is fouled. He will shoot two.
He likes those high layups, kind of like how Steph Curry likes them. Just gets the ball up there and hit off the backboard a certain way, and it falls in.
So that's the thing, too. With 17 fouls, they had one-on-one opportunities for the Falcons. But because of Moss's driving ability, those eighth and ninth fouls came on shooting fouls. So now any type of foul that Yuba commits other than an offensive foul will be two free throws for the Falcons. And with their shaky ability, those one-on-ones are a lot more, it can cause a lot more trepidation because you don't know if you're going to make that first one.
Yeah, and then from the fouls, I'm just thinking attack the hoop, attack the hoop. Because if you could get enough foul calls and play some really good defense, you could get back in this game.
I would anticipate Sean Gray and R.J. Lewis to get a lot more aggressive as a foul away from the ball on the Falcons. Everybody was a little confused. They thought it was an offensive foul, as did I. But it was against the Falcons. Yeah. So Martinez will be subbed out for Jazzik.
Everybody started walking back like it was an offensive foul. But I guess the ref made an error.
I think he just pointed the wrong way.
It happens a lot.
Yeah. Ruaro into the post to Woods. Looks like Solano's going to D up in a zone look. Travis Sell out on the corner. Austin Fjord trying to get it into Eric Sheave. Sean Gray is fouled by Ruaro. Great job by Elizabeth Torres to get out of the way of that one. She's so casual down there. She just kind of moves slightly to the left to get out of the way of Ruaro. But I think she's about the same size as Ruaro. Yeah, she could take him.
She shows no fear, man. She's, you know.
She's a camera person, man.
Yeah, you know, got to get that shot any way you can.
Sean Gray rattles out that free throw. And again, Solano not able to hit those free throws.
Yeah, and like I said earlier, it hurts. It hurts when you can't hit free throws because they're free shots. The time stops. What more can you ask for?
But he hits the second, so that cuts the lead down to 13 here with 6:35 and counting. Corner three from Austin Fjord, and he hits it. That's a big three-point bucket for the 49ers.
Yeah, he didn't have much room, but he launched it anyway.
Ruaro defending the much taller R.J. Lewis as Jazzik squares up for three, and that one is off. But Jordan Moss with a strong rebound out to Lewis. And he spots up for three. That one is short and rebounded by Ruaro.
Yeah, that was a forced shot by R.J. Lewis. Maybe trying to get a spark in the team, get the team going.
And Sean Gray with a nice defense is going to cause Yuba to use one of their timeouts. So Austin Fjord with the three extends the lead for the 49ers to 16. So Yuba playing really soundly here in the second half has extended their halftime lead to this double-digit margin. 5:52, do you think that's enough time for the Falcons to correct some of the things that they need to correct in order to come back in this game?
I'm down 16 points, 5:52 left. I mean, that's eight shots.
Yeah.
Well, 8 two-pointers, you know. Less time, less shots if you hit threes, which R.J. Lewis can hit threes.
And it's amazing. Dylan Collins, no communication with us, can somehow see that he has a camera on him. And he's just cheesing for the camera. He has to get the ref out of his shot, you know. So he has to lean over to his left, getting in the way of Diamond Mitchell. Look, she is having none of it. She's having absolutely none of it.
That's Mr. Showtime himself, Francois Dillinger.
Yeah, Xavier Francois. His namesake is at the PA, Francois Dillinger, a.k.a. Dylan Collins. You can listen to Dylan Collins, my broadcast partner Anthony Williams, and McKenna Guerrero called the Solano-Yuba women's game that preceded this on SCSN. Again, on Facebook, Solano College Sports Network, or YouTube, Solano College Sports Network. As the Falcons pick up a big win for the women's side. The men, however, are down 16 and a foul away from the ball. No shot. So I believe Sean Gray can be called for a hold away from the ball. And that being the 17th foul will create a one-on-one opportunity for Jihad Woods.
Yeah, Jihad Woods having a tremendous game so far.
And so a little chirping, I think, from Sean Gray. Not too happy about that foul call. It's going to get teed up. That's the way you cannot have. Two free throws and the 1-on-1 for Jihad Woods to extend this to potentially 20. George Johnson hits the first one. Johnson really been the spark plug for the 49ers in the second half with his long-range shooting ability to counteract that length that Yuba has presented.
Yeah, he's hit three-pointers in this game, and with those two free throws, now he has given his team an even bigger lead.
18 points, 5:34 left in this ball game. Jahab was back into the lineup, back to the free throw line, shooting 1-on-1. Getting all close and personal with the personal hygiene of R.J. Lewis, drying off his hands.
Sawa Balazi at her finest.
I think she got caught. As that first free throw is good from Jahab Woods, gets a second free throw opportunity. Trying to push this lead to 20. And he hits it. So 73-53. 5:30 left in this game. Pippen kicks it out to Moss, who drives on Jordan Johnson, goes to the hole, and he is fouled yet again. So Jordan Moss really trying to make things happen at the free throw line, trying to maybe hopefully get a basket in there to make it an and one, but really not much touch on those shots, just kind of trying to draw the contact.
Yeah, but at this point of the game, these fouls are good because he's drawing fouls on the other team. Maybe you could get somebody fouled out, get a mismatch for Lorenzo Martinez, and dominate down low.
So Moss, Bryant, and Gray all out of Fairfield High School. Just a fun fact to kind of notice that a lot of these new recruits that are freshmen are coming from the same program, so familiarity with each other, especially people who play in the backcourt together. That's a nice kind of rhythm to bring into your community college days, having played in high school together.
Yeah, you always want to kind of mix it up, get a couple of people from the same high school because they know how each other play, and it takes less time for the chemistry to kind of kick in.
So again, the personal grooming habits of R.J. Lewis need to be attended to. Maybe some blood. Yeah, I think they're trying to wash off the blood on his arm, and they're not able to do so in time. So Robert Jackson will check in. They try to wrap up that middle finger on the left hand of R.J. Lewis. He hits the second one, does Jordan Moss. So after splitting free throws, 19-point ball game. That ball deflected by Chance Pippen, but into the hands of Ostafjord. Francois against Jazzik one-on-one. Nice defense from Jazzik, not moving, but Francois working on the offensive boards and will work to get that foul.
Yeah, it's all hustle. He hits the glass hard, and he makes people pay for it.
Yeah, and you got to like Yuba in this Bay Valley Conference with the size of a Jahad Woods and who am I thinking of? Eric Sheeve at 6'10 and 6'8 as your starting two forwards. And then having a guy like this, Xavier Francois, off the bench with the hustle and the size that you really get a different look from a big man. It's a nice complementing front court for the 49ers. And you add in the bench play of Jackson and Ruaru with the starter of Johnson. Really quality depth for Yuba.
Yeah, they also changed the tempo because in the first half or the starting lineup, we kind of seen them half court offense all the time. And then once Jackson came in and Ruaru, they went fast paced and up tempo.
Robert Jackson with the pull up jumper, too strong. Ostafjord with the rebound. Ruaru back to Ostafjord. Francois looking for a teammate. Nobody comes. Tries to get a hook shot in there, but it is rebounded by Robert Jackson. Pushing the other way to Chance Pippen. Drives past the defender. Throws it up to get that shooting foul call. But Yuba is over the limit, so he'll get two anyway.
And scary moment when Martinez fell. Also fell his probably knee or leg kind of clipped him on the head. So at least he's all right.
Yeah. Martinez kind of has his head down, but looks like he is all right. That's the kind of thing that happens, a basketball concussion that is not as talked about as football, but plenty of concussions happen on the basketball court as well, and it's usually those knees, inadvertent legs, that you kind of fall and you hit the back of your head either on a leg or on the hard court itself. So glad Martinez is all right, as Pippen with the first free throw. Yeah, a little random moment as Ossifier looked to box out Pippen, even though he was shooting two free throws.
Yeah, I don't think he was aware that there were two free throws being shot.
Pippen, the sophomore out of Vacaville. I believe he broke his forearm early in his freshman year. Didn't play much for the Falcons. Really getting his opportunity in his sophomore year to get more substantial playing time. And he's responded with a solid 7.6 point per game average, good for fourth on the team. Jordan Johnson out up top to Jackson. That one is no good. Rebounded by Jazik.
Yeah, Jackson's shot was kind of weird because he shot the ball then turned to the side. But, I mean, if it works for you, it works.
Jazik with the three. That's his second three-point shot.
Yeah, he missed his previous three or four before that, but nice that he got another one.
I'd probably say he's around 33% right about now, which is kind of around the team average of 34%. And that three-point shooting ability is why Jazik is actually third on the team with 7.8 points per game. So that kind of long-range shooting is coming a little late with this 14-point ball game as Johnson rattles that one out. Lucky bounce for the Falcons as he got right past Jackson.
Yeah, the Falcons can still come back, but they need to hurry it up.
Yeah, Lewis looking to operate here. Cross-court pass to Pippen. Spins around. Nice hanging floater, and he just shoots it too long. Kind of indecisive whether he wanted to bank that off the backboard or shoot it straight into the bucket. Didn't hit rim, though, so shot clock does not reset. 9 seconds left on this Falcon possession. Into Martinez. Jazik for three. That one off the back of the rim. Rebounded by Woods.
Yeah, now the Falcons, they just need to play defense.
Yeah, going to need some bounces to go their way. Need a good last 3 minutes of defense to really clamp down. Can't allow too many more points for the 49ers. And they're going to have to get that long-range shot going because at this point with 14 points being the deficit in less than 3 minutes, you don't have that many possessions left to score 14 points, especially if the 49ers start scoring themselves.
Yeah, if I'm Nagel, I'm sending RJ Lewis on some back screens, try to get him open on the three-point line. And if not, then you run a pick and roll and try to get some easy baskets inside the paint.
Or even substitute maybe like a Travis Sell in for a Martinez who's a long-range threat rather than Martinez who's really just a post player. And so you don't really need twos right now, but that's the give and take because Martinez would help on the defensive end to stop Jahad Woods. And so that's kind of the interesting coaching decision that Coach John Nagel will have to make. He's going to have Jazik out there with Martinez, Robert Jackson, Chance Pippen, and RJ Lewis being the other five out for the Falcons right now. So timeout is over. Yuba looking at a backcourt of Brandon Ruaru and Jordan Johnson, as well as Donald Jackson, Jahad Woods, and Xavier Francois. 2:45 left in this ballgame, folks. 14 points is the deficit. 15 seconds on the shot clock for Yuba. As they're swinging the ball around nicely, nice movement. Francois up top, kicks it out to Johnson. Ruaru in the corner, out to Johnson. 3 seconds left. Francois with a fadeaway, little Dirk Nowitzki shot, and it is short. Chance Pippen with the rebound. Off and running in the opposite direction. They have RJ Lewis open on the opposite wing, and he drives, and they're going to call a travel call.
It was questionable. I don't know if he actually traveled. I think he just took like a slow two-step, and the ref might have thought he took a third step on that one.
So big turnover there. They're getting stops on the defensive end with 2 minutes left in this ball game. Ruaru. 10 seconds on the shot clock, out to the corner to Jackson. They can pretty much just milk this clock and just take shot clock violations all they want, and they'll get a shot off, not in time. 30-second shot clock violation. Because if you do the mental math, 140, that's about three possessions of 30 seconds. So Yuba would be smart to just kind of play that ball control style of half-court offense and just kind of let the time run down.
Yeah, and if you're a Solano and you notice that, then that should tell you you need to hit threes.
Yep, like that. Pippen hits that three-point shot. Down 11. Yuba will probably just swing the ball around. They get into the post of Francois, though. He kind of got away with that elbow move, and he sinks that post move. 75-62 is your score.
Yeah, Francois, he loves to put his elbow right in your ribs to kind of move you out the way for so he could get the easy basket.
Jazik, light on his feet with the lefty floater. For the big man.
That's another thing he can do. He can drive to the hole, and he moves quick for a big man.
Johnson shrugging off Chance Pippen, who's playing close defense. 11-point ball game. 75-64 is your score. Eight seconds left on the shot clock. Jahad Woods in the post, looking to put a move on Jazik. Loses the ball, and he puts it back up and in. Didn't actually have to shoot that ball after the offensive rebound, but nonetheless, he gets two more points on that stat line. Falcons will put a little window dressing, try to add on to their 64 points of total team offense. 15 on the game clock. Robert Jackson with a little spin move, looking to do something against the shorter Brandon Ruaru. And Francois settles it. Ruaru will dribble into the half court. And that will be your ball game, folks. Yuba 49ers 77, Solano Falcons 64. Anthony, your final thoughts on this Bay Valley Conference matchup?
Well, Solano, they did a good job in the first half at containing the Yuba offense, holding them to just shooting inside the paint, and they didn't really get much three-pointers off. But in the second half, Jackson was really a boost for them. And Jahad Woods, he really came through for them. And also Xavier Francois, he really came through for them with the energy.
Yeah, so very close game throughout. 49ers pull away really late in the second half. But the Falcons played them tough, and Yuba came in with a 12-2 record, really showed their depth and quality as a basketball club. Moved to 3-0 in conference play. Solano falls to 1-1 in conference play. So that'll do it for us here at the Solano College Sports Network. For Brian Nelson and Anthony Williams, we'll see if we'll have a Best Buy player of the game. Not quite sure if we will or not, but if we don't, we'd like to thank you for watching. Yeah, got the signal. We're not going to have Best Buy player of the game, but we'd like to thank you for watching anyway. Here at the Solano College Sports Network, your final score, Yuba 49ers 77, Solano Falcons 64.